Cruise with the Champions qualifier, so we'll have that coming up. Now, for the most famous words in motorsports, we've got Brittany Moore from the Oak Ridge Advance Auto Parts. Brittany, take it away.
Gentlemen, start your engine.
Race fans, get on your feet. They're coming down the front straightaway, waving at you. Wave back at them. Being called down by our front straightaway official, Lewis Fout. He and Darrell Watson giving them a one to go signal, so bunch them up. Getting ready to go green for this 40 lap Monster 40 here at Wartburg Speedway. Will it be Kerr Marler or somebody else deeper in the field coming to the front to take the $3,000 to win purse tonight? And green flag out. Tommy Kerr getting the advantage off the bottom. And there's a mess down in turn four. Multi-car crash. Multi-car collision down here in turn four. Looks like Sean Shadowen, the 00 car of Reuben Mayfield, the 00 of Brian Ornby. And looks like Darrell Watson's showing them the green flag, so we're gonna try to give them one to go again, see if we can get a lap in the books in this 40 lap, Monster 40. Make a little contact. Kerr gets the jump. Marler goes up high. His car stack up behind him. David Payne gets by. And Anthony White making a dive to the bottom, looking for a way around the 4T of Kerr. Marler up top, getting some of the spots back he lost earlier on the outside of Randy Weaver. Looks like he'll get the runoff turn four, take the spot back. Up front, Kerr and White got a little breakaway from the four car of Ricky Arms. A to David Payne and 157 to Mike Marler, your top five. Leaders already encountering lap traffic here early in the race. The 32 and the 12. They both move over, let the leaders go though, so it shouldn't be too much problem for Kerr or White as they move through the traffic. And looks like the 32 car is coming to a halt down in turn four. Looks like the right front damage on the 32 car. And Kevin Phillips has a little trouble there. Second position back, so we'll have all of our top five intact. Kerr leading White, Arms, Payne, and Marler. See if Marler can make his way back up there after he slipped on the start. Got a little high coming off turn four, had to just keep going though. He looked strong there as he went around Weaver on the outside. See if he can do it again. Green flag waving. Tommy Kerr takes the jump. Front five, single file as they race around complete lap six. Back inside of Marler again for the fifth position. And he takes it away. Weaver back into the top five. Marler falls back to the sixth position. Kerr goes around the lap car, John Stout. White gets boxed up behind him. Arms looks for a way around, but can't make a move. Moved by the lap cars, got Kerr a little room, so now he's got a little breathing room out front as he encounters some more slower traffic, the J12 car, Jeff Franklin, and the 20 car, Brad Coffey. Slicing and dicing his way through traffic, Tommy Kerr making his way up through the back of the field while the other guys in chase try to get their way back to the back bumper of him. White puts a slide job on the 20 car to get up into clear track so he can try to chase down the 4T of Kerr. Kerr making a move to the inside of Scott Gardner, trying to put a lap on the driver from Knoxville. And he makes his way by, keeping his 5-car length advantage over White. Starting to close in just a little on Kerr as Kerr encounters side-by-side traffic there with Brian Ormby and Rylan Dolan racing. And a rolling roadblock there for second. The 12 car, the 00, and the 93 all kind of fanned out in front of Kerr, but still managed to get through there and still holds a 4 or 5 car length lead on White. Caution out on the speedway. Caution out on lap 15 for the stall car over in turn two of Scott Gardner. So Scott Gardner stalls over in turn two, bringing out the caution here on lap to go. Before we give him the green flag, go back to racing action. 25 laps to go in this Monster 40 Advanced Auto Parts Thunder Dirt Car Series main event. Kerr looks for the green flag. Green flag waves, and they're off. Ricky Arm slips a little coming off turn two. Allows David Payne to make a look to the inside. Side by side, down in the corner. Arms holds him off. Up front, White made a run at Kerr, but had to stop before he hit the outside wall coming off two as he slipped up the racetrack, so Kerr got a good advantage after that happened. Back in the pack, H3 car, Kane Hickman making advances, looking for a way around the 157 of Mike Marler. Up front, though, Kerr is just running away from him for a moment while White and Arms sort out the second position. And Hickman makes his way around the 157 of Marler, taking over the sixth position. Good run for the young driver. And we're halfway into the event, halfway down in this 40 lap, Monster 40. Tommy Kerr holds down the lead, so he'll win the Dirt Late Model Halfway Award. Makes another lap over the 12 car, Johnny Stout. Still holding a 5 or 6 car length advantage over Anthony White. White's trying to give chase as they go into the traffic of the slower cars. Kerr comes up to the 20 car, Brad Coffey, putting him another lap down. Making his way by on the bottom in turn one. Challenge for the seventh position. Keith Longmire looking under the 157 of Mike Marler. Not able to make the move though as they race down the front straightaway. And a double zero, Brian Obey. Next car up for Kerr to bypass. And Obey slips up a little, gives Kerr the bottom, so looks like Kerr will make his way on by. Maintain his 5 or 6 car length lead. Lap 30, so Tommy Kerr, 3/4 of the way, 10 to go in this monster 40. 10 more laps, and Tommy Kerr will pick up his first Advance Auto Parts Thunder Series victory. Kerr holds a comfortable 8 or 10 car length advantage over the 2 car of current points leader Anthony White. Ricky Arms, David Payne, and Randy Weaver round out your top 5. Kerr's only got 5 more laps, and he'll pick up his first win of the year, first win of the series. Caution out. Caution out. Looks like the 157 of Mike Marley, the Winfield Warrior, stalls down in turn 4. And looks like we got everybody situated in their position. The double zero, Brian Obey going back into his spot. So the 4T of Tommy Kerr still looking to hold on the last 6 laps in the Monster 40 Advance Auto Parts Thunder Series main event. Flag out. Tommy Kerr jumps down the front straightaway. Anthony White taking his final shots to see if he can take away the victory tonight. And Kerr starting to open up a margin. Ricky Arms looking underneath the 2 of White, but gives him a little room as they go off into turn 3. Pulling back out to a 5 or 6 car length advantage, showing his dominating strength. This will be the 37th lap, so 37 laps in the book, 3 to go. Only 3 laps remain between Tommy Kerr and a $3,000 paycheck. Only 2 laps to go. If Anthony White's got anything, he better show it now, because Kerr's got a sizable advantage. White flag, only 1 more circuit. 1 circuit for Tommy Kerr to pick up his first ever Advance Auto Parts Thunder Series victory. Brings it through 3 and 4. Off turn 4, Tommy the Rocket Boy Kerr picks up the win in the Advance Auto Parts Thunder Series Monster 40. Anthony White second, Ricky Arms third, David Payne fourth, and Randy Weaver fifth. Great run for Tommy Kerr, your winner tonight in the Monster 40.
Race fans, now that he's out of the race car, how about a great big round of applause for the Rocket Boy, Tommy Kerr.
And he's out of the car. Give him a big hand. Rocket Boy, Tommy Kerr, picking up his first win in the Advanced Auto Parts Thunder Series. Tommy, dominating run.
Man, it was unbelievable to drive this car tonight. I got two young guys with me here that they ain't been with me 2 or 3 weeks, and I mean, they
sleep racing here for the past 3 or 4 weeks, and we've threw some deals at this race car. And I don't know, tonight it was just, it wouldn't matter where I put it. I don't know if y'all have ever drove the car late model, but the power steering broke on this thing about 10 laps in the race, and I'm up on top of the wheel, and far out of it. But I appreciate all the fans coming out tonight and everything, and I'd like to thank all my sponsors. I'd stand here all night long and name all of them. They all know who they are. And we just appreciate the help, appreciate these fans coming out and supporting us every weekend. Thank y'all.
Well, Tommy, you know, you're looking forward to local favorites here, Anthony White, you know, one of the dominant forces here generally, so how does it feel to hold off the local hero? And you may have disappointed some people, but I know you're happy.
You know, me and Anthony raced each other real hard during that fast car dash. I tell you what, you beat Anthony White at Wartburg Speedway, you done something. And I'm just thrilled to have the opportunity and the good help and everything to be able to come out and do this every weekend. And, I don't know what to say. I'm so excited.
Well, Tommy, congratulations. We'll see you tomorrow night, Tommy.
Race fans, don't forget, we've got the monster truck. The rules are going to crush a couple of cars out here after we get through with the front-wheel drive event. So be ready for that. If you want to stay around, see.